It was a wonderful presentation, and I think the kind of the studies which were presented by Dr. Dave, he had really established whatever the dilemma which we have in most of the time, that we are concerned about the morbidity as well as the mortality of the procedure. But the bottom line is that the maximum surgical cytoreduction is the standard of care, and HIPAC can add to the maximum cytoreduction in the peritoneal surface malignancies. It is not going to replace any kind of the incomplete surgeries. And with that of the increased experience and the teamwork of the surgeons, as well as the anesthesiologist, as well as the critical care in the sense that post-operative care, in the tertiary care, it is safe. And it is feasible, so there is no question of actually rethinking about the morbidity and mortalities. It is the more and more experience and the data are still required to be more, you can say, robust, so that actually this can be adopted in, especially into that of the ovarian cancers and the other peritoneal malignancies. I would like to have one comment here that we require to have our own Indian data from the various centers, those who are doing the cytoreduction and the HIPAC, to come up with our own Indian results. Of course, we have seen the publications from Dr. Dev as well as Somashekhar, but I think the more and more centers, tertiary centers, can definitely practice it in order to give the best to the patients of the peritoneal malignancies. Thank you.
I think Aditi has been very proactive on the Indian registry, and Aditi, Dr. Sanket Mehta, then Somsekhar and Dr. Dev, Dr. Subramanian Rao, they are doing regular update of the Indian registry, and with that, I think a lot of youngsters are getting stimulated to start this practice with the availability of the high-tech machines in even in second-tier cities like Chandigarh, Hisar. So a lot of youngsters are now getting stimulated to start this procedure. I think propagation of science to the whole oncology community is the motive to give the best outcome to the patient. So with that, we end today's webinar. And Dr. Geeta, if you are there.
I just want to comment on
Yeah, please, please, please.
Dr. Aditi's, your presentations were very, very interesting. And what I felt, because you have started now doing HIPAC, you know, at the recurrence, actually, that is the area of the interest to us. So basically, we will have to believe that yes, HIPAC can be taken up, and maybe at the second time. This can be taken up into the next session sometime, but this is very interesting. And I think if suppose you can develop this registry and we all can contribute to that, that will be a good contribution from the
So also
centers.
we have more than 1200 cases in the registry already. Large contribution from my own center, from Dr. Sanket, from MVR Cancer Center in Kerala, from AIIMS, and several other smaller contributions from another five or six centers. So together we've built up 1200 cases. There are a lot of people who are interested, but they are just not able to, you know, spare time to collate the data and send it over. So the registry has an online system. You can directly enter cases into the database. We have simplified it to meet the Indian requirements. If we have a database that has 500 elements for each patient, nobody is going to be able to do it unless you have dedicated people. We've restricted it to 150, 200 elements. So it's a very simple database to enter data into. A lot of people send us Excel sheets. They send all the data on Excel. So we manually enter it in the registry. In the registry, you can see your own data. Nobody else is able to see your cases, your clinical information, the clinical information of patients. And we have a code for each patient. So you cannot actually see the name and address. That information remains only with you. And if you entered it into the registry and you want to extract your data, you just press a button, everything comes out on Excel. So it's a one-time effort gathering all your data. Once it is in place, you just have to follow it up. It's a matter of habit. Once you get into it, you get started, it is very much possible. And it would be really good because now we are analyzing the 1200 cases, and you will not believe we have a very good survival in our PMP patients. So many 3-year survivors, 5-year survivors. So it is good to see these long-term results because HIPEC remains an expensive affair. And a lot of patients want a good survival. So it is very encouraging that despite the advanced disease that we see, we have good survival in the Indian scenario.
It's a very good conclusion, and I think we will definitely.
Yeah.
And I think with that we end and thank everybody. Our next month webinar will be on hepatobiliary surgery. So we might take up either liver resection or gallbladder malignancy. Let us see what is finalized. But meet you, all of you, next month on the same platform. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Rudra, and thanks to the Oncology Forum.